Frank, we're here to talk about ray tracing. That's kind of your whole business, right?
Awesome, yes. Ray tracing, so exciting.
So we first met at GDC, right?
Yep.
And you were showing off the ray tracing. And I remember thinking, this is a technology that's a cool demo, but when are we going to see it? Did you know back then that here today we'd be sitting here talking about consumer-grade ray tracing capable cards?
Honestly, no. I mean, it was a huge leap, right? At GDC, we're starting to show cool ray tracing technology. And it was like, wow, can we really take this to the next level? Can we get this in consumers' hands and affect games? And that's what we were working towards. We knew that was the goal. And sure enough, behind it came that architecture to really push it. And now ray tracing's reality.
You came on board with NVIDIA fairly recently, right?
Yeah, I've been here about 6-7 months.
Right. So you went from just like discovering that ray tracing exists to all of a sudden, go, 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 we're going to get this into people's hands.
Yes.
What was that rush like for you?
So I'm in 20 years in the industry of all the way back to CG, VFX, then into gaming. So I went from kind of a VFX world to gaming. I was like, oh, you know, awesome. Gaming is real time. But man, CG in the VFX world, it looks beautiful. I'd love that ray tracing technology at some point to be in games. And when I heard what they were working on that, I jumped right on board. I thought it was going to be really exciting.
Yeah, if you've got a CG background, for those who may not know, this is how the industry makes movies, right?
Yes.
But it's just such a costly process to do in a believable way that you can't do it in real time, right? You've got one perspective, the camera, that doesn't move unless, you know, the director or something will move the shot. And then computers just running overnight rendering scenes, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I mean, rendering is hours and hours a frame. Especially in the film industry. But even in games, when you say getting into games, you want to make a level look real, you do a thing called light baking. And it uses kind of this VFX world rendering to ray trace the scene. And it makes lighting look nice and look beautiful. But then you change the time of day, and you got to re-render it again. And that takes hours. So you couldn't do kind of real-time lighting effects that really change the scene. And now I'm moving the sun, and the global illumination is moving around the scene, and it's real-time. I mean, it not only makes the games look and feel better to gamers, but that people actually making the games, holy crap, it's a big leap for them.
Yeah, this is something NVIDIA has been touting as the next big leap in gaming.
Yeah.
You know, like the comparable to the mention of the CUDA core in the GTX 880, right?
Right.
Do you think that's fair? Do you think that's an accurate thing to say, that this is next big leap?
Oh, yeah. Well, the two things together, right? So ray tracing, for sure. For years, game developers had to fake everything, placing extra lights, making reflection probes to kind of fake it and make it look okay. But, I mean, that was countless development hours that they're not spending on gameplay, right? And the fact they get to go, you know what, forget about the fakes. There's a real light here, and it just works. They have to spend more time on level design and more about the gameplay. Now, the fact that this RTX also has AI. We haven't even scratched the surface of mixing ray tracing and AI together. I think we're gonna be blown away.
Yeah, that's kind of the secret sauce here that makes this whole thing work. Why is the AI so fundamental to the ray tracing process?
So it's one thing to do reality in ray tracing. The reason why in film it takes hours and hours to shoot just millions of rays to make things look perfect. When they introduced the AI denoising, the ability to go, I'm gonna shoot some rays, the AI says, yeah, but I kinda know where the rest of them are gonna be. And it filters it out and it makes it look really nice. That made it possible to jump from hours a frame to real time. That was the missing link. And now the ray tracing cores within Turing and, you know, 2080s, that just now increased the rate of rays you can have and the quality you can have. So those two together, is just unbelievable.
We got to see a lot of cool stuff today. I mean, these devs that had this in their back pocket finally revealing it. Did you see any trailer that really blew your mind today?
Well, I'm a big Battlefield fan, right? So Battlefield 5 was like, that's my
I got to agree with that. The Battlefield 5 was a showstopper, that's for sure. Before we let you go, I want to say thanks again, first of all, for your work on ray tracing, and then for coming and chatting about it today here on this couch.
Awesome.